Thanks for stopping by.
The Herd Lie News.
Let me read this first. Don't let the name fool you. Dollar Shave Club has way more than just razors. They have a starter set for just $5. You get shave butter, body cleanser, and an executive razor all for $5. After that, replacement cartridges, a few bucks a month. He's got a Super Bowl ring, although I've never seen it. He's an analyst. Are you wearing it today?
You know what? Next time.
Why didn't you wear it?
Next time I'm out here.
You're not real showy. I wouldn't. I don't see you as
a showy guy.
You're not really.
What do you want him to wear?
Well, he has a Super Bowl ring, and they're usually ostentatious and awful, so he wouldn't wear it.
No, that's not your style.
It's not really your style. We don't hire ostentatious types. We got you and Gonzalez and Rob Ryan. We don't mess around. Okay, so here we go. Listen, here we go. So you've been one of the few.
Jared Goff?
He was not bad. Aaron Rodgers gets hurt. So Chicago's got a rookie quarterback. Minnesota's on their third. Detroit. Still battle for the playoffs? Brett Hundley, can you battle for the playoffs?
Absolutely.
Green Bay can, right?
Absolutely. They're sitting right now 4-2, still atop their division. This is a much better prepared team for Aaron Rodgers being out than they were a few years ago.
Why? Because they didn't have a backup at all?
I don't think they were ever considering him ever going down. And so they didn't have that. When I watch Brett Hundley, he's not terrible. Now, again,
he has. I watched every game he played in college. His accuracy is. And by the way, great dude. Accuracy.
I just feel like when you are able to structurally game plan around a guy, and this is what Mike McCarthy does really well. He prepares his guys really well, and he structures a game plan that fits and suits them to give them a chance and an opportunity to be successful. What we have seen is the Green Bay Packers establishing a running game, so he's not going to be able to, or he's not going to be asked to throw 40-plus times. He may be asked to throw about 25 to 30.
That's fine.
Which is fine.
It's actually what you want from a football team.
Without a doubt. But they need more from their defense. Their defense has to step up.
And by the way,
and create more turnovers.
More injuries yesterday.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah, in that secondary.
Three corners and a safety. Okay, so here's the thing, though. So now this is the second time with Aaron Rodgers' collarbone. He's not Joe Flacco. He's 6'2". He's 222 pounds. I saw him on Men's Health magazine. Mm-hmm. He's not a huge dude. I watched him yesterday, and I'm like, that was not a brutal hit. He actually landed part shoulder, part top of your shoulder. I looked at it, and I thought to myself, do we have the next Tony Romo here?
No, not even close. When you talk about the hit not being brutal, it does not take the brutal hit for guys to get injured in this league. It actually is the hits that you don't see coming are the most subtle hits that end up injuring guys. And it's just a matter of how you land. And again, this tackle, form tackle, whether it was late or whatever.
Oh, come on. It wasn't late.
I don't think it was.
Aaron was ticked. He was screaming.
Absolutely.
At him.
I think he was more ticked because he was hurt.
Okay. Because I didn't think that's not a cheap shot.
No, it wasn't a cheap shot. Wasn't a dirty hit. None of those things. But to say Tony Romo, I get it. This is the second time around with this injury.
Okay. But is it fair to say this? Because of this, he has now moved out of his prime. Four more great years, Aaron's moved. Listen, injuries are part of the prime.
They are. I can't, because of how well he was playing, and he hasn't shown a sign, a steady, or an even a interesting sight of decline.
Yeah.
Potential.
Yeah.
I can't say he's out of his
prime. Boy, he's ticked off, though.
He is.
He is ticked off.
He is. I mean, because when you watch it, he honestly doesn't think that Anthony Barr is going to hit him. He didn't. He did not think. You got to understand, this guy is one of the most protected quarterbacks in this game. Rightfully so, because he is one of the major faces of this league. and you want the Green Bay Packers, the product of the NFL is better when you have a 12 in the Patriots jersey and a 12 in the Green Bay Packers
jersey. What have I been saying for 2 years? Last 2 years, they've let arguably their best offensive lineman go. I like Ted Thompson. So I say, you don't go from LeBron to Kobe. You don't go from Favre to Rodgers. When that happens, it is a historic outlier.
Yeah, he's outside the pocket there. I mean, that had nothing to do with offensive line play right there.
All right, don't go anywhere. What are you going to do anyway?
Nah, I mean, exactly.
Seriously.
Walk over there in the dark.
Just hang out here. We got stuff to talk about. Have you ever taken a cold shower? I did that this morning. I'll get into that in a second.
I hate cold showers.
Yeah.
Good.
No kidding. Company that introduced the world to Wedgie Freeman's underwear, Tommy John. Yeah, you know why I've been pushing Tommy John? Because I'm not an underwear guy.